Yes, of course.
Thank you.
After 1860, Russians built it during the Tsar time. Building by building, block by block, street by street, and they were moving. They were leaving behind them everything destroyed or everything in flames.
Of one thing, that's still in existence, right?
This is Russia. March, April 1940. 25,000 Polish officers were killed.
How far is Lublin from here?
Lublin is 20 kilometers.
Okay.
It's a certain direction. It's about 8 or 9 kilometers straight.
Okay. Do you do tours to Majdanek?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was reducing.
And could the village, the Poles and the local villages hear this or see this?
No, they were around very small villages. Even there is one very touching picture with naked, walking fast woman, Jewish woman.
Yeah.
Also, we have a few original pictures and some were these doctors saying left, right, which is, you know, death or life.
Was that Mengele? Is that what Mengele?
I don't think so. There was among them Mengele, but one of these stupid doctors.
Okay.
Mengele, I think he was more involved in... He was working in the name of, you know, Nazi science, doing different anthropological studies. Among them, fertilizing women, yeah.
Wow. What did your parents tell you about?
We found, for example, the remains of ghetto fighters' weapons.
Yeah.
It means don't think that there were, you know, rifles, pistols. No, we found just detonators made of small glass pipes.
Yeah.
Inside was something explosive, yeah. And when we, you know, threw it, you know, it was like a small, you know, bang, you know. It was the last, and it was the biggest Jewish labor. Kilometers, then we will take right turn.
Okay.
We make right turn.
At Malkinia? Okay, yes. It's familiar with that.
Rock. We'll see in a moment a small Catholic church to the right. Shrines, crosses around. Just behind the streets you see this church and maybe stop where it has. Small, quiet city, still about 40 kilometers from where to the right is this church.
Is Catholic the predominant religion in Poland?
Yes.
Yeah.
Today, about 85%
of okay.
Catholicism. Real Catholicism is 35%.
Yeah.
I think you can understand what does it mean, real Catholic.
Yeah. Okay.
STETL. Okay. Okay.
registration somewhere.
Okay. Thank you.
If you like, I can stop here and you can walk a little bit. You like it?
Okay.
If at the end is also such a place, I will stop also there.
Now, you are filming exactly direction towards the vector.
Yeah.
Constructions to the left, chimneys?
Yeah.
And somewhere to the right was a railway station.
How about that?
It doesn't belong to railway station, right? But somewhere to the right was a railway station.
Are those buildings back there remnants? With the chimneys back there?
To the left, no, nothing. It's
in oh.
Last few years in there, but
oh, okay. It was
nothing interesting. Behind us is Malkia, in front of us, small village Kosufla.
I wonder if there's anyone in this town that's still alive from that time that remembers. You know? It'd be very interesting to speak with them. And Volka Okmaglik, I don't know if that's how you pronounce it, but that's even closer. That's if you go a little bit farther south. Thank you. I get up for a second?
Just,
is there a place
just
I can park?
200 meters behind you
is the camp.
We'll turn right and then we'll see.
Number one, we'll work outside. Just before
this escape, they were planning to together to escape.
Yeah.
Why they were planning to escape? Because, you know, smaller onto this labor camp, yeah. Very close to Treblinka 2.
Yeah, the rail goes past Treblinka 2, and if you keep going,
but
it
maybe
ends
it was,
up Treblinka
you know,
1.
Connected with, it was maybe specially built.
Yeah. Okay.
Of course, take into consideration that this is a deep forest, and there is also the place where we are getting lumber. Yeah.
Yeah.
They were producing gravel pits.
Okay.
No, gravel pits is the place they were producing gravels, yeah?
Yeah. Yeah, they worked in a gravel pit.
Some Jews were sent there also, but mostly it was for political opponents, for political prisoners, for different reasons.
Yeah.
And these are remains from the death camp.
I'm sorry, what was your name again?
Jerzy.
Can you translate that?
Towards railroads, also towards Caucasian mountains,
yeah.
Where are, you know, big sources of crude oil now.
There was
supposed to stay at homes between 11 p.m. and 5 a.m. Jews, 8 p.m., 5 p.m. Mm-hmm. Here, for example, information that these people were arrested and after investigation killed because they were members of illegal organization. They were helping bandits, it means partisans, they called them bandits. Yeah? They were hiding to make stone stairs, for example. Prisoners were working here. They were labeled with different color marks, yeah? They were gold, blue, red. The biggest group was selecting clothes, shoes.
The sorting area.
And also, yeah, the sorting, yeah. And also big, relatively group of prisoners were very busy taking out of the gas chambers' bodies. Yeah? After they did it, they were shaving heads.
Right there.
They were taking out golden teeth, or, you know, different jewelry, which till the last moment people were keeping in different human holes. Yeah. Some of them were so-called specialists, these people who knew jewelry, currencies. Some specialists for Nazis were people who were, for example, musicians. A few weeks, for sure, lived these who were working closer to mass graves. Yeah? Because every few weeks they were exchanging them. Yeah? They were killing this, and from new transport they were selecting small number of young Jews who are able, most probably who are able to do such a job. Specialist, or better work, what meant in the past, mostly access to additional food.
Yeah.
And it's very tragic, but better condition for. We were talking earlier about this huge escape from the camp, but here you have a picture of constructions of the house for the Ukrainian family. just after the escape, few weeks later, they decided to destroy it, you know, and then the whole this territory looked like a big farm with such a few buildings, you know,
yeah.
And they left two Ukrainian families here. They gone just before coming Russians, you know, because in the middle of 1944, this part of Poland was invaded by Russians.
Oh, look at this. Something in Hebrew.
Something in Hebrew.
That's amazing.
Germans.
Yeah.
Let me show you before war, Polish territory. Here's the basic information, yeah, about the number of people who were killed, yeah? And this is the symbolic ghetto gate. And behind this concrete construction is a former death camp space. Yeah? You'll see to the right symbolic railroad, and in front of us, about 200 meters, you'll see.
Okay. Wow.
These bigger stones are like
the train.
The fence of former death camps. Yeah? They are symbolic. Memorial was made of 17,000 stones. We have this memorial from 19.
camp here.
Two barracks, but construction of the motor. From this side, you can find like faces of dead people. From other side is menorah. And as you see, it's broken in the middle. Like was broken their lives. Like their lives were broken. You can see here different city names.
Very interesting idea to design in such a form this memorial. You know that it's very traditional stone on Jews. for Jews.
Yeah.
And in this ring emblems archive, you can find some a lot of course ring emblems notes.
Yeah.
But also invitation to the theater, kids pictures, because schools were closed, but a lot of people arranged, like, you know, private lessons for the private schools for them. Of course, it was unofficial,
yeah. Yeah.
And he visited Ringemloh, visited such a school, few such a places, and they asked kids, write a little bit about situation you see around you, and there are very touchy drawings, for example, with, you know, lying or dead person in the front of building, or very touchy kids notes. I don't know what will be tomorrow, for example. You know, again, I'm hungry. My family is hungry, yeah? Yeah. And it's very, very touchy part of this Lincoln Bloom's house.
Yeah.
Including these places where they were in different labor camps. Almost every time I'm visiting this place, it's such a beautiful weather.
Yeah.
Such a nice clouds.
Perfect day.
about Warsaw University National Stadium, built for 2012 European Football Championship.
Ja mu później mówię, więc wyszliśmy, mówię, kurwa, człowiek, ona nie poleciła. O, dobrze, dobrze, dobrze.
Thank you. Thank you.